In this video, we'll be looking for lookup function. We have earlier seen for VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP how it works for vertical table and horizontal table. Now let's see how lookup function works. On the screen, if you see, I have some data given here, that is the income and the tax. Now, if I put here income in this place, I should get tax from this table, which is retrieved using lookup function, not by VLOOKUP. How do I go for it? Now, I'll just type here a function as equal to lookup, right? Equal to lookup. Once I open it, it shows me two formulas with different parameters. I'll go with the second one. It says as lookup value comma array. For me, the lookup value is this one, and the array which is belongs is second this entire table. So I'll select this as lookup value comma, and this is my table array, that is array in short they have called this, and without the column headings, and I'll press enter. That's it. So for 5000, because the 5000 value is not present, I'll insert some value which is present in the table. Let's say 25000 insert. So for 25000, it is showing me as 25. You see here, if I insert some value, let's say 6000, which is present in the table, it says as $20, which is absolutely correct. But now, if I insert some value which is not inside the table, let's say if I insert 4500, which is absolutely not inside the table, what is the answer expected? If I use VLOOKUP, how do I get it for approximate match? It goes above in the upper column and it gives me the answer as $15, because 4500 is not there. Now you see, I've got the answer as $15. So it's working fine for this. So what is the benefit of using lookup function? I do not have to use four parameters. First thing, second thing is it's very short formula. And another thing is lookup function works for vertical table as well as horizontal table. So this was for vertical table. I'll show you something that's a horizontal table. I have just copied and transposed its data. I'll keep my cursor here and I'll try to find out this value. This value is not present, so I'll insert some value which is present in the table. This one, 25,000, enter. Now, I'll type a lookup function, same, no change, equal to lookup. That's my lookup value, comma, and this area is my lookup, what do you call, lookup array. You can say a stable array or simply array, either of them. So now if you see, I will write only two parameters, not more than that. Even earlier one, I have written two parameters and I'll press enter. For the answer for this value is 25,000, I have $30. So once I press enter, I'm getting $30. The answer is absolutely correct. Let's try one more. I'll insert some value which is 6000. So I'm getting the answer as $20, which is absolutely correct. Let's see whether approximate match will it capture or not. I'll enter here as 4000, some random value which is not present. So expected answer, you see 1000, it is less than 6000. That is, it comes in this range, $15. So the answer is absolutely correct. So parameters are, you know, it has saved you, your time will be saved here. Next one I have this kind of table, where if you see there are different types of columns here, which is the ID, last, first and email, phone number. Now what I want is, when I insert some ID number, I should get the phone number of the person, respective person. So how do I use it? Similar to that formula, only two parameters. One is the lookup value and second is the table array. That's it. So I'll use equal to lookup and I'll use this lookup value comma, and this is my table array without the column headings. That's it. So I'll press enter. So for this number 48, the last two digits, if you see 48, I have the phone number, that is 34, last two digits, and I'll press enter. So the answer is absolutely correct, 34. Now what I'll do is, I'll not type and change the numbers, I'll just copy paste it. So I'll press Ctrl C and I'll press Ctrl V here. So you see, for 53, the answer should is expected is 23, which is absolutely correct. It's working fine. So this way, the lookup value is belonging to the first column of your table array and the result vector belongs to the last column of your table array. Now you might be wondering, if I do not want the last column as a result vector, how should I get it? So for that, I have one more example given here, this one. In this place, I want ID number and I do not want email ID, I don't have. I want the first name. So I'll just delete both of them and I'll type here as first, enter. So now, once I put ID number, I do not want the last column, I want the third column. How do I get it? Same function, I'll use it. The only difference, if you see in the function, I'll show you, equal to lookup, open bracket. That's my lookup value and I'll select this entire data. Now, if you observe the previous example and this example, my lookup table is only till this place as a last column. So first name of the column is first and that belongs to the last of my table array. And once I press enter, I'll get with respect to 49, this one, I'll get this name, that is Pineflow, and press enter. So you see the answer I've gotten. Similarly, if I copy this number 50, Control C and I press Control V, so I've got the answer as Kurt, so which is working fine, right? So this way, lookup value will help you to reduce your time and effort, and it works everywhere. So lookup is evergreen. Let's see one more, the next one which I have. Lookup for full record. Now what exactly full record means is, suppose I have this number as 48 that is the ID number. So with respect to 48, I do not want any one value, that is email ID, phone number or first and last name, nothing. With respect to that ID number, I want the entire record to be displayed here. So how should I go for it? So same lookup function can be used here, right? So I'll just keep my cursor in the formula. The first function or the first formula, you have to write it properly, and rest all can be easily, you know, just drag and fill. So let's see how. Three parameters you have to remember for lookup function. First one is lookup value. That's my lookup value. Where does your lookup value belong? Lookup value belong to this lookup vector in this column. Third one is, what is your result vector? For this one, if you want this value, result vector is last. If you want this one, the result vector is this one. If you want this phone number, result vector is this column. So let's see, we'll go for the function here, equal to VLOOKUP, equal to lookup. Select the cell, that is the lookup value. So I've selected the cell lookup value. Second is lookup vector, that is my lookup vector. So I'll select here lookup vector, right, comma. And third one, it says look, what do you call, result vector. So I'll select this result vector here, and I've got the answer here. And I'll press enter. But before pressing enter, if I drag the function here on the right hand side, what will happen is A17 will become B17, C17, D17. So my lookup value is this one. It should be fixed. It should not change. So I'll keep it as fixed. Similarly, my lookup vector is also fixed. So I'll make it as a dollar sign. How do I make it? I'll make it as fixed reference. The shortcut key to make it as fixed reference is press F4 from a keyboard. Cursor in between and press F4 from a keyboard. This one is locked. Similarly, if I want to lock both this lookup vector, I'll press F4. Similarly, I'll press F4. So that's it. These are the only minor changes you have to make. Rest the formula is easy. So I'll press enter now. And if you see, I've got the answer. I'll just drag right on the right hand side. Let's see whether the answer is correct or not. For 48, that's the number 48. I've got this name correct, and the number which is 34, which is absolutely correct. I'll just try one more example. I'll try to copy this, which is given here 50, and I'll paste here. So let's see whether the entire record gets pasted here. Control V. Yeah, it's working. Something has come. So for 50, if you see the caller and Catherine and the name is given here, caller, Catherine, everything. So it's working fine for the record. So just remember this function or the formula, how it is. Lookup value, I have the lookup value. Next, I have the lookup vector and the result vector. Using this, I'll get the entire record. So I hope you have understood all these lookup values. That's all for this video.